Hi everyone, my name is Amanda and today I have my February wrap-up and my March TBR. February was such a good reading month for me. I managed to read 4 books and all of them were freaking amazing. I loved every single book that I read this month and I can't even remember when that loss happened, but they were all so great and I can't wait to share my thoughts on them with you. So without further ado, let's just jump straight into the video, shall we? So the first book I read this month was a Swedish book called The Emperor of Portugalia, or Kejsaren av Portugalien in Swedish, and it was written by Selma Lagerlöf. It follows a Swedish family during the late 19th century, and the father, he is very miserable with his life, but then when his daughter is born, he really comes alive and he is reborn in a way. But then the economic problems start to accumulate and the daughter moves to Stockholm to be able to provide for the family. And the father, he can't handle this loss of his daughter. He can't handle being away from her, so he becomes crazy. He becomes the Emperor of Portugalia. And it's just a really beautiful story about loss and longing and love in its purest form. I thought it was very well written and I really enjoyed the writing style. It's quite simplistic but still very, very beautiful. Some chapters just had the most beautiful imagery and I just think that it's a really good portrait of love and insanity and response to insanity, I guess. So I would definitely recommend this book and I gave it 4 out of 5 stars. So the next book I read was a book that I really, really loved and it was The Enchanted by Renée Denfeld, and I like this book a lot. I have a full review of it where I go into detail to why I like this book, but it follows a prison and all the inmates living there, both on death row and just in general. Our narrator, who is an inmate of this prison, tells everyone's story, and we especially get to follow a lady trying to get a man called York off death row, but also other inmates in the prison and outside the prison as well. It is beautifully written and I enjoyed it so much and I gave it 5 out of 5 stars, and I would definitely recommend going to check out my review because there I really go into detail to why I like this book so much. So the next book I read was the classic of this month, and that was Pride and Prejudice by Jane Austen, and I have never read anything by Jane Austen before and I really liked this book and I thought it was so cozy and just heartwarming. I really like to read about this era. I think it's just such an interesting time period to read about in general. It follows the Bennet family, who is struggling to get all their daughters married to men of high caliber, I guess. It follows a period in their lives and the main character, Elizabeth, is just a really interesting character. I think that this book just has some really interesting things to say about Pride and Prejudice, of course, and I thought that it was very well written. I love the language. I actually started reading it last year, but my English just wasn't that great back then, so I couldn't really make the most of it, but I feel like the language just helped this book so much. And I really, really enjoyed it and I gave it 4 out of 5 stars. So the last book I read this month was absolutely amazing. I loved it to pieces and it was Station 11 by Emily St. John Mendel. I have no idea why I haven't picked this book up earlier because it was freaking fantastic. Definitely one of my new all-time favorite novels. I will be filming a review of this, which will be up in a few days, so I will leave a link to that video once it goes live. This is a dystopian novel which follows a large amount of characters, both before the Georgia flu, which wipes out 99% of the population, and after the Georgia flu, and we follow the Traveling Symphony, which performs Shakespeare and music in this post-apocalyptic world. It is really well written, and while the writing isn't very adorned, I would still say that it's really sharp and really on point. It's about resilience and it's about art and how art will prevail as long as humanity does, and it discusses really well what is important to us and that we shouldn't take things for granted. And I really enjoyed this book, and like I said, there will be a review up soon, so keep your eyes out for that. I gave it 5 out of 5 stars. It went straight to my favorite shelf and I want to reread this like right now. So that was all the books that I read in February and I completely adored every single one of them. Like I said, I won't be making any real TBRs since I want to pick up the book like when I want to pick it up, but I know that I will be reading Den vidunderliga kärlekens historia, or in English, The History of the Wondrous Love. It is written by Carl Johan Wallgren, and I have no real clue what this book is about, other than that it follows a dwarf, I guess, who was born in a brothel, and he just struggles through life. He is deaf, and he is deformed in some way, I think. But he can also read other people's thoughts. And while I think this is a book about love, it is definitely also a book about revenge. And I can't wait to read this because it's said to be a really great Swedish novel and have to read it for school, but I'm still really excited to read it. And the classic of the month that I will be reading is totally inspired by Station Eleven because I completely love that book and I want to read more Shakespeare. So I have decided to read Hamlet by William Shakespeare this month. I'm really only familiar with three Shakespeare plays. I have read Macbeth and I have read Romeo and Juliet, and I have watched The Merchant of Venice, and I definitely want to widen my knowledge about Shakespeare and his plays, and therefore I will read at least one play this month, and that will be Hamlet, but I also think about maybe reading Othello or King Lear, since that is featured in Station Eleven, and I hope they will be great. So that was pretty much all I had to talk to you guys about today. I would love to know what your favorite book of the month was. Please tell me in the comment section below. I would love to know. And I hope you all have a lovely weekend, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!